better get ready. Bow to the masters. Break it down!
Yeah. What's up, guys? You're William Savage back again for another NXT live reaction. Raquel Gonzalez versus Xia Li and the NXT Women's title is on the line. You know what I want to do? Shout out to Raquel Gonzalez. Since she's won that title, she just keeps defending it. You know, sometimes we have the champions to win the title, but all their matches after are the singles matches. She just keeps defending it. Xia Li's been out here knocking out people for real because she's a real badass. And that's a character that you don't want to mess up because you've got it perfect. Yes, you don't want people getting hurt for real, but once they do get hurt, use it in a storyline. You know what I mean? As long as they're not seriously hurt, use that in a storyline. And Raquel Gonzalez is just a beast, man. When I look at how the rosters and that go, Raquel Gonzalez, the size of her, the look of her and everything, that's somebody they could really use on the main roster. And I, you know, my feelings on Dakota Kai, that woman's got championship written all over her, so there's loads they can do. So let's get into this. I'm going to go for Raquel Gonzalez for the win, obviously, but you know, you never know. I mean, you do. They're pretty predictable. Look at the legs on Xia Li, man. I don't mean it in a pervy way, I'm not like that, but look at the size of her legs. Her legs are all quads, massive, for such a small person. She's in super shape, man. Very believable that she can kick your ass, and obviously with Raquel Gonzalez, very believable she can kick your ass as well. NXT's been good today, but we've had the Kyle O'Reilly versus Austin Theory match, very good match, very technical match. Like Austin Theory, man, he's got a bright future ahead of him, and because he started with the comedy and not a big push, oh, it's perfect for him. There's no pressure, he can just build as he goes along. We had the breakout tournament, that's looking really good. Some superstars there and some future superstars. And we had Frankie Monroe versus JC Jails, something like that. And we had Mandy Rose out again. Oh, I love that move. The Mandy Rose thing is a bit weird, isn't it? Because she kind of fits into NXT straight away, which she shouldn't when she's been a superstar on the roster for such a long time. She was doing great before that that hacker storyline. In my head, Mandy Rose going into the pandemic after Sasha and Bayley, I thought would have became champion. Honestly, I thought that. I don't think she's incredible in the ring, but I think she's really good. She's definitely got the look. She keeps herself in shape. Probably in one of the best shapes in WWE, her and Naomi. You know what I mean? Carmella's looking lean now as well. A few of them. Oh my god. A senton like that from Raquel, she's dead. But Mandy Rose has everything. Something a little bit missing. I don't know if it's on the mic work. I think they always push that thing with Mandy Rose, like when she talks on the mic, everything has to be super sexy. She has to move sexy and say, but it comes across a bit cheesy. And it feels like someone's told her what to say. Whereas someone like Carmella, apart from when she does that, Mella in money, that's cheesy. But apart from that, she's incredible. Like, that's somebody who's worked at their craft and is very believable. In the ring now, on the mic, looks great. But hopefully, and I've got nothing but like positive vibes from Andy. I would like her to, you know, push on. Wow. Dominant performance from Raquel. Is it just me, or can anyone else not like look at Dakota Kai without thinking she's got a heel turn, or not a heel turn because she's heel, but she's got like a she's got it in there to just turn on Raquel anytime. I can see it, man, so much, especially watching the Tegan nuts before. I think it's because it feels like Raquel just got pushed ahead of the queue past Dakota Kai, which she did. And it's a perfect storyline. When she wants to, she can just tear her up. Say, listen, you push past me, and now, you know what I mean? Has that Diesel Shawn Michaels thing about it. But yeah, man, as I was saying, with the roster, I just hope that, you know, I just want positive vibes for all these wrestlers, man. You know what I mean? I'm trying to have a bit less of negativity, a bit more. more constructive criticism kind of thing, you know what I mean? I don't want to become one of them armchair pundits, man. They don't know what, you know what I mean? He just speaks like they know everything what's going on. Too many people doing that now. I see it in my comment section all the time, telling me stuff from, they're telling me this inside stuff, and I'm like, I'll search the internet, and I'm like, blah, blah, this person never said that, and Daniel Bryan never mentioned this, but, well, how do you know? Like, Brie doesn't know, Daniel Bryan doesn't know, but you know. Example, innit? It's very weird, very strange. Stay out of people's business, you know, like that. It's what it is. I've been your boy, good to have it. Comment, like, subscribe, and share with Raquel Gonzalez with the win.